Hey everybody, it's Angie and welcome to Hot and Flashy. Today's video is on how to get started with a prescription retinoid, Retin A, for anti-aging without irritation. Now I had done a video on this about 3 years ago, but I thought it was time to update it because I have been getting so many questions from viewers who watched my skincare routine that I put out a couple months ago. They went out and bought everything that I use, started applying it every night just like I do now, and are having a little bit of trouble with their skin acclimating to it. They might be having a little bit of irritation, but what you don't know if you haven't followed along with me on my entire almost 6 year journey here on YouTube is that I didn't start using them every night when I began. I started very slowly with them. I eased in over time. I wanted to completely avoid that irritation reaction. I didn't want red, flaking, peeling, burning skin that looked twice as old as it was so that I could use them in the long run, not quit, and actually have success with them. I had also read a study at the time that said that the irritation reaction was not part of what made Retin A work, so that if you could avoid the irritation reaction, you would still be getting the benefits of Retin A, but without having the side effects. All right, so you've got your prescription Retin A, you've got everything else from my skincare routine, you can't wait to put it all on your face the first night and every single night after that and watch the years melt away within a couple of weeks, right? Nope, wrong. That is not how anti-aging topicals work. They do work, you will see the results, but it's going to take a while. I mean, even the research on Retin A shows that it takes at least 6 weeks to start seeing results. When I started with it, I didn't really see anything happening in my skin until 9 months, a year. I could really see it going on in 3 years and 5 years, so I feel like the longer you use it, the better. So in order to set yourself up for success instead of setting yourself up for failure, you kind of have to forget all the marketing claims and all the advertising these days that makes us believe that anti-aging skincare should happen in a week. So I think a mindset shift is in order if you want to use this. It's definitely a less is more product. The less Retin A you put on, the better. The less often you use it at first, the better. Of course, the goal is to use it every night, to get up to a strong enough strength of it that you will see the changes in your skin, and you will get there, but it will take a while. And just accepting that it's going to take a while, that it's fine that it's going to take a while, that is all good. The first thing to consider is what strength you're going to use. You don't always have to jump in at the strongest strength on everything, and everything is available in different strengths. So like with Retin A, there are 0.02%, that's like the lowest strength, and it goes all the way up to 0.1%. So I started kind of in the middle at 0.05%. You might want to have a conversation with your dermatologist or your doctor about what strength you should use. If you know you have super sensitive skin, then you might want to start lower. If you know you don't have sensitive skin, you might want to start higher. That is up to you. I can't really recommend because I don't know what kind of skin you have. If you don't have a dermatologist, you don't want to go see a doctor to get it, to fill the prescription, then to have it filled at your local pharmacy. There are other ways to get a prescription product like online. One that I use is Curology, and this is how I get my prescription tretinoin now. They have medical professionals who work with you one-on-one to develop your formula. And they recommend what percentage of tretinoin they think you should start with, and then the prescription comes to your house. It's on like an automated refill once a month shipping thing. I absolutely love this product. And if you want to try Curology, I'll put a link in the information box below the video. You can try it with your first month for free to see how you like it. So that's how I get mine. But in the past, I have used the generic tretinoin cream when I was getting a prescription from my doctor and just having it filled at my local pharmacy. And with tretinoin, less is more. So you're not going to pump out a big, you know, line of this on your finger and have a white coating of it all over your face. The instructions generally are to use one pea-sized amount of the cream for your entire face. So it's going to be a little bit, and it's fine that it's a little bit. If you use a lot of it, you will get more irritation. So you're going to take that pea-sized amount, you're going to dot it around your face, one dot on your chin, one on each cheek, one on your forehead, and then you're going to rub that in. But you are going to avoid some areas of your face to avoid that irritation. So the skin around your mouth, the skin at the sides of your nose, underneath your eyes, and on your eyelids are more sensitive than the skin on the other parts of your face, so you are going to avoid using it there to start. We are eventually going to get it there, but it's going to take a while. So you've got it on there the first night. Now what are you going to do? Are you going to put it on the next night and the next night and the next night? I don't recommend it. Again, less is more with Retin-A. So when I first started, I only put it on once a week for an entire month. Then the second month, I put it on twice a week. Then the third month, I put it on three times a week. And that whole time, I was watching my skin for signs of irritation. So you have to also get in the mindset of listening to your skin. That if it starts burning, if it starts feeling dry, if it starts feeling red, if you have a ton of peeling that you don't like, that it's okay to cut back. You can drop back to what you were previously doing, do that for a couple more weeks, see if it adjusts. Your skin should adjust over time if you do it slowly like that. Unfortunately, there are a certain group of people that will never adjust. There's about 15% of the population that just can never use prescription tretinoin. If you're in the other 85%, you should be able to acclimate to it eventually. So if you put it on that way and you wait a week and you have no irritation, then you're probably fine. You can move forward like that. If you put it on the one time and you've waited a week and you've had some irritation, then you may need to do some other things to help your skin to acclimate a little bit more. One of the things that you can do is you can wait for your skin to dry after you wash it before you put it on. If you watch my skincare routine, you see me wash my face, towel my face dry, and then put on my Retin-A. I can do that now. But when I first started, I wasn't able to do that. I had to wash my face, then wait 15 to 20 minutes for it to dry completely before I put on my Retin-A so that I could avoid the irritation. If your skin feels like it's drying out during that time, you could put a little serum or a little moisturizer on, and that's fine. Then still wait the 20 minutes, then put on your Retin-A. You can also put moisturizer on top of it to help with the irritation. One of the serums from my evening routine is my Timeless Sin 6 serum. This is a peptide. Peptides are very moisturizing. These are also made with other moisturizing ingredients like glycerin, aloe, and hyaluronic acid. So if you wanted something to buffer that was lightweight before you put on your prescription retinoid, that is a good thing to put on first so you don't feel like your skin is drying out while you're waiting to put on your retinoid. But the way that I used it is I didn't put on anything first. I just let my skin dry. Then I would apply my retinoid. Then I would apply this right after, and I would use that, and I would put this everywhere, including on my eyelids and including on my lips and all those places that I avoided with the Retin-A. And then just smearing this to those places, I feel like it just would move a little bit of the Retin-A over to those places, so they were getting a tiny bit so that they were getting acclimated to it. Another moisturizer that you can use is the CeraVe PM Facial Moisturizing Lotion. You could put that on before the Retin-A, or you could put it on after the Retin-A. The CeraVe PM contains niacinamide, hyaluronic acid. It has ceramides, which are fatty lipids that help to moisturize the skin. So these are great moisturizers. Another one that I've been using for years that I put on after my Retin-A is the Olay Regenerist Micro Sculpting Cream. This one contains niacinamide and glycerin and another peptide, so it's a great moisturizer, very hydrating to the skin. So that's the first thing. Then the second recommendation that I have is to make sure that other things that you're using with your prescription retinoid are all very mild and gentle. These are all super soothing. They don't have any acids in them. They don't have any SD alcohol in them. And that includes your face wash. So if you're using a foaming cleanser, or if you're using a toner that is full of SD alcohol, I would stop using those. I would switch to a non-foaming cleanser. There are a gazillion of them on the market. The ones that I've been using for years and recommend are the CeraVe Hydrating Cleanser. That's a good non-foaming cleanser, very moisturizing. The La Roche-Posay Toleraine Hydrating Gentle Cleanser. These are just about identical ingredient-wise. Then I also have used and like the Mad Hippie Cream Cleanser. So those are all good cleansers. To remove my makeup, I use an oil-based balm, the Clinique Take the Day Off Balm. That's very soothing. And so if you do find that you have a little bit of peeling, I would not recommend using a harsh scrubbing cleanser or doing anything to help accelerate the peeling. I don't think that you need to immediately jump into a lot of exfoliating. I think exfoliating can be too irritating to your skin. I've heard of people taking their Clarisonic and really scrubbing at their face with their Clarisonic. You know, I just think it's too much. You want to be nice to your skin. If you want your skin to look nice, you have to kind of be nice to it. And so I think that stuff is just too harsh. I would just use lukewarm water on a washcloth and just gently rub the one spot where the skin flakes are. You don't have to be scrubbing your whole face and making it all red. The toner that I use is from Thayers. It's their alcohol-free witch hazel toner. There's another toner that I just got from Colleen Rothschild. That's a matcha green tea toner. It doesn't contain any SD alcohol. It's very soothing and very gentle to the skin. Now, if you are having an irritation reaction on your face or on your neck, one thing that you can do is get like a specialty cream that is supposed to be super soothing, super calming, super moisturizing. I did just discover this one from La Roche-Posay. This is their Cicaplast Balm B5. I've been trying to use my prescription Retin-A on my neck lately and just use it like once a week and just patting the remnants of what's in my finger, and my skin still does get a little irritated, but I find if I put this on and then sleep in it, my neck is so much better in the morning. Anytime my neck is having an irritation reaction, I put this on and it pretty much takes care of it within a day or two. So that's a really great product to try as a soothing, calming moisturizer. You can use it on your neck, you can use it on your face, you can use it anywhere that you're having irritation. So applying my Retin-A that way, by the end of the year, I was using my Retin-A every night, and then I thought, okay, maybe it's time to try putting it underneath my eyes. So I started doing that and I didn't have any irritation because that area had acclimated just by having it around there as well, and I was already starting to see a little bit of the results. So then after that, I wanted to go up to the next strength. And so in order to do that, I didn't just dump the 0.05 and start using the 0.1 every night, because of course it's twice as strong. I kept using the 0.05 every night, except for one, and that one night I would bring in the 0.1%. And so I pretty much did increased my nights of using the 0.1% just like I had when I started using it, but a little bit faster. And so it probably took me 6 months to introduce the 0.1% and get up to using it every night without irritation, and that went fine. And so that's what I've been using now for the last like 4.5 years. I wouldn't start using any other products with acids in them along with it until my skin was acclimated to the Retin-A. So if you're one of the people who bought everything from my skincare routine and started using it, then on day one, you were putting 3 different acids on your skin, and that might be too much to acclimate to all at once. So I would stick the vitamin C in the fridge, stick the lactic acid in the fridge, hold off on using the Drunk Elephant Sukari Baby Facial until your skin is completely acclimated to the Retin-A. Now, if you've already been using other acids and your skin is fine with them and you've been using them for a while, then you can start just working in the Retin-A, okay? But if you haven't used any acids before, I wouldn't start 3 acids at once. Now, people often ask, like, is it okay to use them at the same time? In general, yes. They're not going to do anything to harm each other. They're not going to harm your skin. They actually can work very symbiotically together. So you might want to get to the point where you can use acids together, like a couple at night or a couple in the morning. But then I would ease in with them as well and let your skin acclimate to them. So if you were doing my skincare routine and you had already acclimated to the Retin-A and you wanted to add in the next acid, the one that I would choose is the Timeless 20% C plus E Ferulic Acid, the Vitamin C Serum. I would start bringing that in. And I would do it similarly to how I did the Retin-A, except I wouldn't do the waiting 20 minutes after I wash my face. These other over-the-counter acids are not going to be as irritating to your skin as the Retin-A. So I would start bringing them in one at a time, maybe try it once a week. After a couple weeks, if everything goes well, then go up to twice a week, a couple more weeks of that, everything goes well. Within a month or two, you're up to using them every night. And then the third one I would bring in is the lactic acid, get up to using that every night. And then I use this Drunk Elephant TLC Sukari Baby Facial. I do this once a week on like a Sunday night as a little peel. And on the night that I use this, I don't use my Retin-A. One of the things to remember with Retin-A and with the acids is that it's really, really important to use sunscreen with all of these things during the day, because it does thin out the top layer of your skin, the stratum corneum. That is a protective layer. It protects you from some of the sun's rays. So you need to wear sunscreen every single day with this, at least an SPF of 30. It has to be a broad spectrum sunscreen. But what I found in the beginning is that even the sunscreen irritated my skin when I started using Retin-A. And I discovered that it was the chemical sunscreens that irritated my skin, specifically avobenzone and homosalate. So I would switch to an all-mineral sunscreen. There are a number that I've tried and that I love. One is the Make Prem UV Defense Me. This one is really lightweight. It works great under makeup. It is an all-mineral sunscreen. Another one that I like a lot is from Hydropeptide. This one's very moisturizing, so it's great to use when you're trying to acclimate to a retinoid. It is the Hydropeptide Solar Defense SPF 50. It has antioxidants in it, and it's really good for your skin and maintaining the integrity of your moisture barrier. Another one is Elta MD UV Physical SPF 41. This is another moisturizing sunscreen, so it's a good one to use when you're trying to acclimate to Retin-A as well. So I have lots of related videos to this one that I'll put in the information box below, as well as I will link them up here underneath the eye. Things like how to put makeup on over peeling Retin-A skin, my current skincare routine, my Retin-A 5-year results videos, and my Retin-A video from my ingredients series, where you can learn all about retinoids, what are the best ones, what works, what doesn't, and why you would want to use one, as well as product recommendations. So I've given you a lot of product recommendations here today and told you what has worked for me in the past. As you know, and as I always say, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a dermatologist. I just research, I look into this stuff, I try to learn as much as I can, and I want to pass on the information that I've learned to you. Am I doing it 100% the absolute right way? Probably not. But is there a 100% absolutely right way? Probably not. Even dermatologists don't agree on what's the right way to use Retin-A and how to put it on and if you're supposed to moisturize or if you're supposed to wait 15 minutes or whatever, what you can use it with. So I don't think there is one, but this is what worked for me, and I hope it will work for you. So thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful and informative. If you did, give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you get notifications when I upload another video. And as always, you know, I thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate your watching. So have a great day, and I will see you in the next video. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.